I came to dance, 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 dance. Yeah. I hit the floor, cause that's my plans, 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 plans. I'm wearing all my favorite brands, 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 brands. Give me some space for both my hands, 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 hands. You, you, cause it goes on and on and on. And it goes on. Came to move, 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 move. Get out the way of me and my crew, 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 crew.
What's up, what's up, what's up, my high? It's your girl, see you.
And I'm okay. What was that?
Oh my god.
Are you okay?
No, that was so scary. And I'm like hyperventilating.
Here, CJ, eat a Snickers.
Why?
Because you get a little oversensitive when you're hungry.
That's not true.
What are
you talking about? Stop hurting me. God.
Better?
Really? Well, better.
Good. So where are we anyways?
I have no idea, but let's go to Vanessa Andrew with catchphrase so we can get out of here.
That's a good idea.
Oh, that's embarrassing.
Yeah. Hey, hold on. I think I'm getting a call. Who's there?
Never say who's there. Don't you watch scary movies? It's a death wish. You might as well just come out and investigate a strange noise or something. Do you want to play a game?
No. Please. Please don't kill me, Mr. Ghostface. I want to make it to the sequel.
Don't worry, guys. It's just ketchup. Just like my mom puts on her spaghetti, baby.
And remember, guys.
I see dead people.
Look, he just had a knife.
No, it's a knife. Okay, we can't have a knife.
That is like creepy.
Hey.
Oh my god. What are you doing?
What? What are you talking about? Nothing. Oh, me? I'm just, you know, trying to figure out my costume, you know? Out of zone.
Okay. So what's your favorite scary movie, Cindy? I mean, CJ?
Oh, okay. My favorite scary movie, let's look. Who's been the shady one now? Let me see. Oh, The Conjuring. The Conjuring. I love The Conjuring, you know, with the boom and the
Yeah, I don't really know what you mean. I guess mine would have to be Friday the 13th, but the remake because it's Jared Padalecki in it. But never mind what I just said because okay. But let's just have Kia, LaMaya, and Bree show us their top 5 movies.
Introducing your new Jeepers Creepers.
Hello, Lawton High, and welcome to your new and improved Jeepers Creepers. I'm Kia.
And I'm Bree, and we're going to be bringing you our top 5 horror films. Starting at number 5 will be Hills Have Eyes. There's nothing creepier than going on vacation with your family and getting ate by cannibals.
True that.
Hello, imagine the first people that crossed this desert, they didn't know where they were?
Yeah, I can, because neither do we.
Hey, get up. Tell me again why we couldn't fly like normal people.
Did you find a signal?
No, nothing.
They're like people. There's something living in those hills.
If you're gonna eat something, eat food. Stick to what humans were made to eat, please.
Are you alright? I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
I just found this tied to a tree back there. Somebody did this.
We're looking for a phone.
Sweetheart. Baby, seriously, this isn't funny.
I know you guys have all heard this story. It's one of the scariest, I would say.
The kids of Elm Street don't know it yet, but something is coming to get them.
They're gonna kill me for sure.
Did you do it?
There was somebody else there.
He was locked in a room with a girl who went in alive and came out in a rubber bag.
No one knows where it came from or who it will visit next.
Do you believe in the boogeyman?
No.
Whatever you do, don't fall asleep.
And at number one, we have Michael Myers. His mask, I don't know, it's creepy, but...
It was inspired by Alfred Hitchcock's Psycho and defined the slasher genre. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we'll be taking a look at the Halloween film franchise. In 2007 and 2009, the series saw a complete reboot when Rob Zombie was brought on board. To capitalize on the tremendous financial success of other recent 3D horror films.
Now, where did that girl go?
Ah!
Chill! You need to chill with that girl.
Sorry.
You better be sorry.
All right, well, I mean, you were just trying to scare me earlier.
No, I didn't.
No, you did.
Why?
When you had the knife.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, okay.
All right, choose.
Truths. So what did I miss anyway?
Nothing much. I was just going to introduce the segment without you since you wanted to act childish and goofy.
Well, then don't mind me. Go ahead and do it yourself.
Fine, I will.
Good.
Yeah, boo. All right, it's time for Minute to Win It with Serena and Jessica.
That's right, Mom. It's time for Minute to Win It. Serena Almantine, and I'm Jessica Fagan with this week's Minute to Win It. Today is a challenge I like to call Noodling Around. Today, the obstacle is to pick up 6 penne pasta noodles placed around the perimeter of a table, only using a piece of uncooked spaghetti in your mouth. And for today, we have the legendary Mr. Brandenburg and Miss Barry. So, Jessica, who do you think is going to win?
Oh, Miss Barry definitely has this in the bag.
Please.
Well, looks like we'll have to find out in 3, 2, 1.
I'm Miss Barry. I teach world history, and that is...
I'm Mr. Brandenburg, world famous geography teacher, also known as the winner.
Okay, noodles in your mouth. Get ready, set.
Did she just say we're learning about idiots?
I don't know.
Check. Check 1, 2. All right, here goes nothing. Timing's everything, stop telling me you're taking your time. I know you're anxious, but you're running your mouth like you're 5 years old again. It's so hard to pretend. Like I know everything, I don't know anything. I wanted you to see that I got nothing.
I'm Sean.
And I'm Nikki here with the On Fleek Report.
All right, Lawton High. This week, me and Nikki have been on the hunt for looking for 2 individuals who exemplify fleekliness.
Oh, yeah.
So, we had a hard time deciding, but the very first winners of the On Fleek Report are, drumroll please, Houston Gill and Tanner Gardner. Houston, you look good.
Tanner, you look good.
Thanks.
Holy moly, guacamole! Houston was looking so fine.
I'm pretty sure she's way ahead.
I'm gonna marry her.
What?
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 What are you talking about?
What?
You love her?
What?
I love her.
What?
What? I didn't say anything. Anyway, it's time for sudo.
That's judo.
What's the difference?
One's real, one's not.
Oh.
What are you trying to say anyway?
Sudo.
The sudo report?
Yeah.
Man, I gotta go.
Where are you going?
I gotta go change for the sudo report.
This is your LHS pseudo report with Sydney Cohen.
Amanda divorces his wife after just 3 weeks through WhatsApp by comparing her to an apple. A prankster takes his own spin on village road signs. A woman takes a dump on a Los Angeles suburban law, and a Supernatural season 11 premiere on today's pseudo report. A man divorced his wife after just 3 weeks by using WhatsApp and not being able to communicate with those all over the world. The two were in an arranged marriage by the 21-year-old college student's mother. In the message, he says, she was like an apple and he already tasted it, so he didn't want her anymore. A European prankster decides to lift the mood for drivers on a local village road by adding his own spin to the village signs. It was in the prankster's turn to laugh, and all those who saw the signs sued him for making them crash their cars. A woman in Los Angeles really shows her love for the iconic middle class life. The woman, currently unknown, decides to take a dump on the lawn. She dropped her pants in plain daylight and, relieved herself. She followed up by leaving the paper she used to take care of the business right there in the middle of the street. Personally, I don't get why everyone's getting upset. I mean, she was clearly just trying to fertilize the ground. These two shows have created such amazing fans that two sisters who call themselves the Hollywood Show on YouTube have made such iconic parodies of these two well-known shows and many more. Well, that's all for today with the Pseudo Report. I'm Cindy Cohen. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for joining us today.
And don't forget,
have a happy Halloween. Got a blast. Man, Houston looking so fine.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure she's like way out of
town. I'm married.
What?
What?
What
was that?
What?
I love her.